Hey everybody, welcome back. Dr. Cranky in the Lab-RAT-ory. We are going to continue now to stage two painting of our rusty cap and our rusty cap challenge. As you can see in the background now, we've added a few more colors, including this kind of like deck green gray, which is there. I don't know if I'm going to use it, but I kind of like it. We've added the next bright color, which is, I believe, the color we're going to start out with. All right, yellow. And then we've got these two different kinds of greens. And then, of course, this is sort of an intermediate, like yellow green. So that's it. I mean, we're gonna do that next. We're gonna show you that we've once again resalted the cap. Okay. Now notice that we've added just about as much salt again as we did in the first round. The only difference now with stage two, of course, is that you can actually control the salt. You could, you look through it and you find your rust spots that you want to, preserve. So we have a lot of salt everywhere, but in places where you want more paint to adhere, you could, with your finger a little bit, you could remove some of the salt, from just to give a variety here and there. You could, and then the color, of course, will in fact go on. So you'll see that next. All right. So I've got my handy dandy Iwata Neo set up with my, I have a valve control for the PSI here, and it's a quick connect so that we don't mess around, we don't waste too much time. Make sure that your airbrushing is in good working order. Get your handy dandy paper towel, shake up your paint. Of course, I pre-shook the paint, but it never hurts to give it a couple more. And this is the reason why I love these York top bottles. You could just put enough paint on them, okay? Just a couple of little drops. All right, I'm gonna turn on the compressor. Here we go. We're gonna test our paint. There it goes, all right? So we're gonna also clean our tip, even though our air is working just fine. And now we are going to come at it and, just put paint where we want to put the paint. So here you're coming, like I decided that the yellow is gonna go on the inside of the cap. That's why, so we're concentrating the color in certain places. Again, you don't wanna erase all of your previous work. So this is kind of selected airbrushing, my friends. Okay, you just go slowly adding a little bit of color in places where you want yellow to show. It doesn't have to show up everywhere. Again, it's variegated, all right? So now we've got plenty of yellow, and of course we ran out of the color just in time. Perfect, absolutely perfect. So now we are going to take this green and we are going to put just a few more drops in there. It's okay for your colors to mix initially. I mean, that's part of the low stress. We don't really care. Plus you can run it out of the airbrush. See, it came through because I had run out of the yellow. So the same thing with the green. Where are you gonna put this green? Well, we wanna put it in places, again, random places. See, it's coming through now. Maybe a little bit there and a little bit around the edges, maybe in a couple of places. You are essentially painting over the good work that you've done, but with a slightly more control now, Okay, and once again, we ran out of the paint. Okay, now it's kind of moist, so I am going to, and this is going to make more racket, I am going to take my hair dryer and I am going to dry the cap, because I want control over it, complete control over the paint, over the moisture, over everything. Now, okay, so that's pretty dry. Okay, and so you begin to see some of that light color on there. Now at this point, once the paint that you've applied is dried, you could actually come back in and resalt. You can re-moisten and resalt. Okay, I like to dry the paint first, then moisten with water and add the salt. Okay, and that's, I'm going to do a little bit of that up next. So that you'll see that, okay? So you'll see that process. All right, so as you can see, we resalted, okay? So you see the yellow and then this green, and now some of you asked me, well, you know, how do I remove the salt? Well, you could use your finger, or you could use a toothpick, or you could use a fairly stiff brush, and you remove the salt from places where you want the paint to adhere, have better adhesion. And then, you know, so it's at this point, it is in fact a little messy, you know, and you can, you know, you can do things like streak down in a downward motion like this. Notice that the salt is pretty pretty stuck on there. Okay, so just a little bit goes a long ways. Okay, so and don't worry, you can get your surface cleaned later. Here we go again, our handy dandy airbrush. All right, so we're gonna fire it up, and now we're gonna come in with this color on the outside. We're gonna work backwards. We're gonna do the outside, and then I believe I'm gonna use this color for the inside. So that's what we are going to do. Once again, a few drops. Okay, this time probably just a little bit more than normal. See, get paint on my hands and fingers, and you don't want to make a mess, obviously. Let me turn on the compressor. Here we go. Once again, test your paint. It's working perfectly. And then come back in and add your paint. This time we're adding a little bit more coverage to the paint, okay? We are gonna be covering a bit more. So that it's, you could see it there. We're taking on more paint, more paint surface, just so that it's a little bit more subtle. And you can spray over the salt quite a bit, so that's okay. Sometimes you want to avoid places where you've put some preliminary shading or some nice areas around the edges where the rust is looking, you know, peeking through. So right there, that's pretty good forming. There's a couple of yellow spots there. So see, a lot of the yellow has been pushed back, but when you remove the salt, some of it will come back up. So, and part of this is gonna be the color of the lid. So, you know, we're trying to create a variety between the outside and of course, the inside of the lid. So just, you know, and then once you get that done, of course you can empty your spray into a paper towel like this. Until it runs out. That's why we work in drops, and believe me, drops, there, it's not gonna go anywhere. You're not gonna waste that much paint, so you're okay. You just wanna blow it out. like that. Okay, so now we get our gray, and I know that watching the drops go in there is not that much fun, but you know, it's part of the process. Once again, test your paint. See, they're still green, but now here comes that gray. And with the gray, now we are gonna hit up spots, just, you know, where we initially applied some of that green. You wanna leave a little bit of that yellow and a little bit of the green, but the rest you wanna, okay, if you run out, of course, common sense tells you, just add a few more drops. Not a big deal. There we go. Okay. So you begin to see some of that dark gray and some of that dark green, okay? So at this point, we are done. With at least this stage. All right, everybody. So let me show you now where we're at. We finished with the colors that we wanted to put in, and look, yet another transformation taking place. I'll bring it closer so you can see it, and I can talk about it. You see some of those colors. Now, this is the end of the second stage, okay? And a lot of things are showing through that I like, and then there's something that overall is bugging me, and that is that it's still a very light cap. I want it to be a little bit darker, so I am going to do one more video showing you one more round, okay, one more stage in the painting process, which will involve once again resalting everything, and we are going to take this and make it much darker, okay, and then I think I want to resalt the inside here as well and put in maybe an orange color, believe it or not. Make this a little bit brighter and make the outside a little bit darker, all along, of course, retaining some of the wonderful rust and chipping that we have all over this cap, which you can see right there. You know, pardon my ugly fingers, but there you have it. You see the shading of that black that we initially put on there, that has disappeared into the back, but it's still there, okay? You could still see it. The eye retains it, and that's the beauty of this process. So we've gotten already at the end of stage two, and we have, you know, we have some very good looking rust coming through and old paint. These things in the field get painted time and again. All right, maybe the gray is old primer, I don't know. There's some nice chipping going on back here. You know, let me take my little pointer. That chipped off, and it took with it the the primer even, you know. So what do you do with it in a case like that? Well, you leave it. It's perfectly normal and perfectly in scale and absolutely beautiful when those kinds of accidents happen. So, you know, embrace the accidents. Of course, we're not doing anything to the inside, but there you see some of the original primer, you know, black, gray, and ruddy brown. So we are going to take this through another stage, and then after that we begin the fun continues with pigments, washes, gunk, junk, more lotions, more of everything. So stay tuned in, my friends. More Cranky Show coming up.